Greetings, everyone. In today's feature, we will explore a cherished classic, Maurice Sendak's renowned children's book, Where the Wild Things Are. This illustrated novel, published in 1963, has captivated audiences with its remarkable storytelling and evocative art. We shall embark on a voyage through the book's plot, followed by an analysis of its significant elements. Let's dive right into it. Where the Wild Things Are opens with a young boy named Max, who wears a wolf suit, causing a ruckus around his home. His defiant and boisterous behavior prompts his mother to send him to his room without supper, labeling him as a wild thing. Max's imagination begins to take over, transforming his mundane bedroom into a captivating forest landscape. Max's room changes, first with a single tree sprouting, then a forest growing, until finally the walls dissolve entirely. Max finds himself in an extraordinary world, an enchanted jungle, under a sky illuminated by a private moon, surrounded by a vast, seemingly endless ocean. He sails across this ocean for almost a year to where the wild things live. The wild things are enormous, monstrous creatures, each uniquely designed by Sendak, with their horns, claws, and fanged smiles. Despite their terrifying appearance, they're not initially hostile. Max stands tall before them, captivates them with a piercing stare into their yellow eyes, and effectively tames them without fear. Impressed by Max's audacity, the monsters proclaim him the most wild thing of all and crown him their king. He commands them to participate in a wild rumpus, a celebration of his new reign, where they swing from trees, stomp around, and howl at their moon in wild abandon. Max, in his role as king, orchestrates this symphony of chaos with the wild things as his loyal subjects. Eventually, though, Max begins to feel a sense of longing. The exciting, chaotic world of the wild things cannot replace the warmth and comfort of home. Max, though king of all wild things, starts to feel lonely and decides to return home. The monsters don't want him to leave and express their desire to keep him with them. They promise him they'll be good, but Max knows it's time to leave. Max relinquishes his crown and sets sail back across the ocean, leaving the wild things behind. The wild things howl their disapproval and roars echo in the distance, but Max is undeterred. He sails back into his reality, back to his bedroom, where everything is as he left it. The final image we are left with is Max sitting at his dinner table, finding his supper waiting for him, and it's still hot. This poignant moment signals that despite his wild adventure, his home remained a constant source of warmth and love. The story ends on a comforting note, reminding readers that home is where we truly belong. Now that we've journeyed through the plot, let's explore some analytical insights. Where the Wild Things Are is more than a mere children's story. It's a narrative layered with profound themes about childhood, imagination, and emotion. Max's journey into the land of the wild things symbolizes the exploration of one's emotions, particularly feelings of anger and frustration common in childhood. His wolf suit, an extension of his wild behavior, enables him to express these feelings freely in his imaginary world. The wild things are physical manifestations of Max's emotions. They are wild and untamed, much like Max's feelings at the beginning of the story. Sendak portrays the power of imagination as a tool for managing emotions. Max uses his imagination to escape into a world where he gains control, a stark contrast to his real life, where he is punished for his behavior. The wild rumpus, a celebration of freedom and chaos, represents the apex of Max's emotional exploration. However, the longing for home and love eventually brings Max back to reality. Sendak subtly conveys a universal truth. Despite the exhilarating allure of unrestrained freedom, the security and love offered by home are unparalleled. Additionally, the book's ending serves as a reassurance to children about the constancy of parental love, signified by Max's dinner waiting for him, still hot. Even after his time in the wild, Max finds comfort and warmth at home, underscoring the theme of unconditional love. As we conclude this exploration of Maurice Sendak's Where the Wild Things Are, it becomes evident why this book remains a beloved classic. It beautifully encapsulates a child's journey through complex emotions, emphasizing the power of imagination and the unchanging warmth of home. If you found this summary and analysis insightful and you would like to explore more literary works, I invite you to subscribe to this channel. Your support aids in the continuous production of similar content. Till the next feature, remember, the wild rumpus continues in the world of literature. Thank you and take care.